This production of Belle is very different from anything you might have seen before, such as the Disney version or anything that you would read to your kids.
It definitely has a darker, more mature theme to it.
And it is a little scary, but not too much.
A traditional pas de deux would be something like that you would see in maybe Sleeping Beauty or Swan Lake. It tends to describe the relationship between the couple.
Normally there's a lot of presentation. The man offers his hand, the woman takes it. The partnering is very traditional. Normally the man's hands are at the girl's waist, and it's all very elegant, and the woman is usually on point.
Whereas a contemporary pas de deux, like in Belle, there tends to be a lot more off-balance positions. There are no rules in regards to where you can partner someone contemporarily. So it can be from the hip and the back at the same time. There's a lot of different ways in which you can manipulate the body.
I think one of my favorite aspects of this ballet is that Belle is not on point. She's the only woman on flat, and normally we associate in ballet this idea of beauty and the point shoes and the ethereal quality. But Belle is so grounded when everybody else is on point, which allows that contrast and makes you think of what beauty is and how you can find beauty in different things.
The classical foundation that the dancers have in traditional and classical work definitely informs how we portray our contemporary movement in something like Belle Redux. The pas de deux work can actually be very similar to traditional pas de deux in the sense that the relationship is still a very important part of what you're introducing to the audience. So when the Beast first meets Belle, there is the more of a timid aspect, not just from her, but also from the Beast, because they're really getting to know each other for the first time.
At first, Belle is very afraid and intimidated and doesn't know who this person is. And then throughout the pas de deux, he keeps handing you a rose. And that is like he's sharing a little bit about himself with you, and he's more vulnerable.
There's definitely a higher level of intimacy in the second pas de deux versus the first pas. The last pas de deux, you're really getting an inside look at their relationship.
It's very romantic and sensual. The music is beautiful. And at the very end, when the fabric gets all wrapped up into a rose, it's just Stephen Mills at his best.